spin this plate for 20 seconds. Keep your eyes on the plate for 20 seconds. So when I say look at the rabbit, look at the rabbit. Here we go. Here we go. I'll count the 20 seconds. 20 seconds of looking at this, then look at the rabbit. Here we go. Mississippi 1, Mississippi 2, Mississippi 3, Mississippi 4, Mississippi 5, Mississippi 6, Mississippi 7, Mississippi 8, Mississippi 9, Mississippi 10, Mississippi 11, Mississippi 12, Mississippi 30, Mississippi 40, Mississippi 50, Mississippi 60, Mississippi 70, Mississippi 80, Mississippi 90, Mississippi 20, and look around.
Oh my God! Good God!
What was happening to the rabbit?
Oh, he's a gorilla!
So you reckon it expanded?
Yeah.
Sort of expanded. But, did it really expand? Are we, some people say, did it feel any heavier in your hand? No, not really. Well, we've got, what do you think had happened? If I spin it the other way, that time I spun it clockwise, what do you think it would happen if I spun it? That's nice prediction, sir. Going smaller, I can see lots of people going smaller. Okay, here we go. Whoops. Mississippi 1, Mississippi 2, Mississippi 3, Mississippi 4, Mississippi 5, Mississippi 6, Mississippi 7, Mississippi 8, Mississippi 9, Mississippi 10, Mississippi 11, Mississippi 12, Mississippi 13, Mississippi 14, Mississippi 15, Mississippi 16, Mississippi 17, Mississippi 18, Mississippi 19, Mississippi 20, and you're right.
Oh!
Now he's shrinking back down to his normal size.
Fantastic.
And that's an illusion. Of course, it's not getting any bigger, it's not getting any smaller, really. What's happening is we're tricking your brain, tiring a little bit of your brain out, so that when you look at the rabbit, not all of your brain, just a few cells in your head, in your brain, fall to sleep. And that gives you the illusion of something expanding. It's a whole bunch of science concerning illusion. Wonderful thing. But people, you just keep holding the rabbit. Because I've got something I wanted to show you. Air, but it can travel through air. Anybody? I got to, in fact, get your hand like that and give you a clue. Get your hand like that. Put it gently against the side of your throat. Don't squeeze too hard. And on the count of 1, 2, 3, give me a good hum. 1, 2, 3, hum. What do you think? I like it. But I'm a scientist, you see, so I can't believe you unless there's evidence to support. This is the way science goes. So here's a piece of evidence that I brought with me. You might know it as... Whoopee cushion. Are you ready, sir?
A fart box.
You ready, madam? You ready, madam? There you go. And hopefully you heard a bit of stuff and you saw a bit of stuff. But today I want to talk to you about the extremes of science. We're into the extremes of science. And so let me show you another whoopee cushion. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. So it's mobile phone inside a balloon. Sort of. If you know what I mean. By using science. Right of four. If you're gonna try it yourself, do it over your bed first. I did drop one or two mobile phones as I was learning how to do that. So try it over something soft first. Do have a go. It's not all that difficult to do at all. Whoa, wait. You seem to like sound science. So still. Now, who was that wonderful person who held my phone for me before?
It was yourself.
Well volunteered. Well volunteered. Thank you very much indeed. And your name, please. Excellent. Thank you very much. What I'd like you to do is hold your fingers out like that. We're going to put this here. Fingers in your ears. That's it. And then bend forwards. When I drop this on the floor, use your knees to make it bounce. It'll look a bit strange. Obviously, in the name of science, so that's all right. 3, 2, 1, go. Go,
sort of sea and stuff like that.
Some people say it sounds a bit like a heartbeat. Lots of people.
I can't hear my heart.
Lots of people tend to say.
Yeah, it does actually.
Sounds a little bit like science fiction.
Yeah.
You know, like I'm going up in Star Wars.
Yeah.
I